Here's the thing about this matchup. It's just by spaces, I feel like it's very hard for Ryu, but Ryu has gotten a lot of new stuff. So Tatsu into neutral air, I'm not sure if it clanks and in Ryu's favor, but I feel like any sortie versus Ryu is bad for Ryu. Ryu tries to get in. The projectiles, though, smart usage and that grab missing. Very unfortunate for Tispai. He did have the read there to punish.
Tried to use the armor through the up B, but McB using the down tilts to invalidate that.
Okay, McB. All right. Oh, he is throwing out some stuff right now.
This is a very unique neutral that they're playing right now. Like, we're seeing McB try to come down with focus a lot, but only using that as, like, a movement tool, you know, not really trying to use the armor to get in a good position.
Yeah. Here's the thing about Ryu. If you are at 80 plus, you're gonna die.
Just the way you explain that, I mean, like, isn't that the case for every character? Like, they're just gonna die.
Yeah, you're just gonna die. I mean, especially with these new buffs, I feel like it's not gonna be good, but McB definitely needs to find his way into Tispai right now, and it's not happening.
We talk about rage, we need to be making a case for both of these characters, because I'm definitely one of those players that gets a lot of benefit out of rage. But speaking of rage, that Tatsu coming
Oh my gosh, he did it the other way. If he did it, oh, that's so unfortunate. And you see McB kind of looking over like, oh, are you kidding me?
McB almost about to make Ryu look godlike. You know, that videos, right?
Yeah, that would have been a clip or something. He would have true focus into down air or something like that. That would have been scary. You're definitely right though. Ike has a lot of kill options, just like Ryu. Just Ryu looks a lot more fresh now, just because of these new buffs that have been put in.
Yeah, I think it's just that Ike can really do a good job catching the landings that McB wants to jump in with, but it's really hard for Ike to get around the setup pressure, the armor, and the projectile game that Ryu has.
Okay.
Like, a lot of ledge trapping that Ryu can do with down tilt, especially with focus, can mitigate some of the armor harassment that Ike wants to do with up B.
Yeah.
In the nair? Off of it?
It's very close, man. One thing about Ike, those up airs are so scary after the nairs.
Exactly.
You get very scared, so then you start wanting to air dodge, and that's when Ike shines, when you start getting scared of him, because he will exploit it. Not dead, though. Good DI.
Yeah, very hard to effectively DI Ike's aerials.
Yeah,
because of how monstrous and strong the knockback is.
Yeah, really good call out that he knew he was going to side B and just waited for the shield to side B the first hit and then just punish with up tilt. Oh, that's going to be it.
Jab into the Shoryu! Let's go!
Do not get scared of Ryu options. Do not air dodge in. Just don't. Especially against Ryu. Yeah, Ryu's will be like, okay, you air dodge in free Shoryuken, you know? So it's not a good option.
It's so much easier for them. Yeah.
Man, these characters, they trade like the damage output from both of them is just kind of stupid.
Not only Tatsu being like invincible on the leg when you use it now is such a great buff for Ryu, just the knockback
that's
being so consistent is nice, but the up air is nicer for Tispai.
Yeah, Tispai spacing that nair, and then if you let one nair go, he gets that other one, and he looks for that up air. And sometimes it's just true, man. No matter what percent you're at,
yeah,
or not true, but at least
you're just gonna die to it if it connects. Mm-hmm. There's little you can do at later percents to stop characters like Ike or Lucario, or even the Shotos for that fact, whenever they use their killing moves.
Yeah. It's just brutal for both. Both these characters kill so like, they have such heavy hitting moves. So, you know, it really was anybody's game.
It's like you say, like, people are going to die. there's no room for, like, gimping or anything like that in a matchup like this.
You know, there's like, you see other characters, but then you see these two, and it's like, for some reason, they're like middle heavies, you know? They're not even heavies, but they count, kind of, just because of how much hard they hit.
Yeah, and not only that, but how well they can be comboed by majority of the cast.
So it's really interesting to see the dynamic between the two, because they just throw hands at each other, you know? Hand and sword at each other.
Yeah, and they love staying in each other's face, despite Ike having a lot of range. No, Ike definitely does not play as, like, a zoner aspect of a sortie, you know? It's really all about him getting in, doing that heavy damage, and making you pay for making a mistake.
Yeah. Oh, that's going to be up air. Not going to hit.
Just by trying to fall through the platform with these nairs, maybe get a juggle situation going against this Shoto.
Oh, really good up tilt by McBee there.
Okay. All right, he has him above him. What is McBee going to do in order to silence this nair pressure?
Yeah, the one thing about Eichmann is if he just spaces those nairs, you have to respect it. You have to play patient. And that makes neutral sometimes a pain. If you're an impatient player, it's not going to pay off. But McBee starting to show some patience.
Great defense, avoiding that back air from Ryu coming in. This one has been not letting Ryu get too much advantage with the stage control.
Down tilt to side B, not going to kill yet. Still really good. Oh, side B, the instant back air, trying to catch out the punish, and he did.
That's just going to delete him outright. All right, so two stocks to Tispai right now.
Ah, man, unfortunate. That side B, man, is so strong. I believe that was buffed in this latest patch.
Which one for?
The side B, the Tatsu.
Yeah. Has invincibility on the leg, I believe, now?
Is it more strong, or is it just the invincibility now?
I'm not entirely sure. I believe it did get a little bit of a knockback buff as well, too, but if anyone knows in the chat, yeah, please let us know.
Yeah. Okay, that's going to be up air.
The Shadows did get a little bit of unique buffs, especially with their down smash and Tatsu as well, too, so...
McBee, you're not need to miss input like that if you want to win this match and stay in the tournament. And miss inputs like that are going to cost you a lot. Tatsuing offstage, which is very unfortunate. And now Tispai has a lead and is up a game.
Rather surprising flub we're seeing from McBee, unfortunately. Tispai, though, getting back to stage and fighting to get some stage control with
If there's one defensive move that's tilting to get hit by, it's that ether, and then he hits you three different times, and you're like, I just got hit. It feels like you got hit by a bunch of things.
Especially if they're edgeguarding with it. It's just not fun to get hit by.
It's very much not so. And now, McBee kind of evening it up. All right, showing some life here.
All right.
Getting the focus hit.
Yeah, all right, getting another one. Coming through in clutch.
Okay, Tispai starting to lose his lead now. He has lost the lead.
And it's not like Nair's like such a fast tool that you can't intercept it. I mean, that's frame 10, so you can at least see it coming when it activates. But like getting the reactionary parry is definitely troublesome for McBee. He's at a percent where he can die to hard shore you.
DI! I think that had to be bad DI. There was no... That was like 120?
Man.
Tispai, I think he DI'd straight in because I don't think he wanted to be off stage, and he ended up DI'ing that very bad. Otherwise, he could have been just dead even if he DI'd well, but...
All right, now, cool. I knew it. It did get a knockback buff as
okay,
well.
Okay, so it got knockback buff? Yeah, that might have actually just killed then.
And this is scary. Tispai counter pick to Smashville. Okay. I don't know how well that's going to go as Ike for this matchup.
The problem I have with Smashville as Ike, and it's probably he knows probably something that we don't, but a problem I have is that now that Ryu has a shorter stage to get to you.
The biggest thing. It's just he's just dead.
Zero to death, and that's
as what we're close about. He was as just get him. Uh-huh. Yeah, he just stays in your face, and Smashville is just a small, very close, engaging stage. You do not have time to run away.
That was utterly disgusting by McBee, and what a way to open up game three. And now Tispai is definitely behind here.
Yeah, he's feeling the hurt, that's for sure. Tispai has already had a strugglicious time.
Oh my gosh, the focus down air! Oh my, he had the read on that. McBee is kind of showing up in game three here.
Barely misses the air dodge punish, but you know, this is so much damage right now on Tispai. He can rack up some more.
What a great counter. Tatsu, this is going to be edgeguard? Easy edgeguard. Oh, what an air dodge to get back.
Oh, but he still goes with the uppy, the armor coming through.
All Ike needs is a good F tilt, and Ryu will be dead at ledge.
Wow, that Chakunetsu was so clutch.
Oh, McBee stopping the focus. Really good by him. Tispai's going to be looking for that nair or back air, especially right now.
Oh, man, that nair is coming through and validating him dropping shield so much.
Okay, there it is.
Finally sneaks in a back air right there.
Yeah,
back air, kind of much more reliable than most of his like aerials and stuff.
Yeah, well, one thing about Ike is he loves to delay those aerials. You know, and delaying back air, people just need to hold shield against that back air or wait it out because most Ikes are going to do it as low as they possibly can.
But the thing
which
is,
mixes
like,
up everybody.
Oh, 100% I agree. The thing is just that back air is just like a really fast active out of shield option, like frame 7, so he can just reactively like punish a lot of like missed like grounded options on platforms.
Now McB, he had a huge lead. Tispai starting to close that gap with the back air. It's going to be, oh my gosh, that was so close to being it.
Ryu's
a little heavier though.
Look at all of this.
Still living. Good DI and stuff by McB. That's it though. And now
counter
Tispai
coming through. And Tispai with a pretty shaky lead right now.
You
but
see
if he can just keep this together, he will be in control of this entire match.
You're definitely right about that.
Another upbeat. Yeah, he's stopping the aggression that McB is trying to admit, but the Shoryu coming through.
That man was just like, yeah, you're going to jump here. I don't care if I'm on last stock. I'm going for this heavy read on you. I know you're going to do this. And now, very even for game three, last stock, man.
Yeah. McB's already evened it up with just a few hits.
This set has kind of been wild. Both
it
of them swinging back and forth. This is very, very close.
Like we say, we're not going to see too much of like gipping stuff here. They're going to just flat out die to each other, getting up close and in each other's face personally.
The focus, they're trading so evenly.
Not going to send him into a crumpled state though, so he is going to have to chase for the pressure.
Tatsu, what is Ryu doing? I'm not sure if you wanted to show you first.
Oh, but the roundhouse kick and you're gone, McB! With the 2-1 reversing the situation and putting him back in the game.
Roller coaster of a game. Roller coaster of a set right there. Back and forth, going back and forth on the leads. And we're like, oh, okay, now Tispai has it. Oh no, McBee's starting to read him on game one. And then game three was like the exact reverse. And it's like, who's going to take it? But McB on that Ryu, enjoying the buffs. I know he's kind of earned them. He's been wanting them for a while. He definitely stuck with Ryu a lot of the time. So good on McB. Tispai, unfortunately, he has to drop out of the tournament now because of that. But, you know, still good job on him. I believe he
made
fifth.
Good.
Fifth is not bad. Making fifth.
That is it for me. It has been a pleasure commentating with you guys tonight.
Oh, said I commentate two sets. Get me out!
Dude. I have seen some great matches tonight, but I am
tired.
Absolutely. I am going to get out of here and going to enjoy watching the rest of the matches from home. Big thanks to everyone. Big thanks to Cal letting me come out here to commentate for you guys tonight, but I am going to be swapping off. Aira, been a pleasure as always.
Pleasure, bro.
Everyone in the chat, take care. Peace out.
Right, yeah, see you later, chat. I'm going to mute my mic.